One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Tape recorder, Vin?
It's a tape. No, it's our latest song, actually. It's called Bad News. Although you probably worked that out. It's a sort of statement.
A statement? Yeah. On what?
Oh, it's a statement on, I'll tell you later, right? I only just got up 6 o'clock in the morning. You expecting me to blow your mind? Listen to the lyrics.
Pardon?
I said listen to the lyrics, the lyrics.
What sort of feeling have you got about the tour?
What?
What do you feel about the tour?
Tour?
Yes.
Yeah, we're going on tour. What?
There's somebody at the door.
Oh, no, we've got a toilet.
Oh, the door. There's someone at the door.
What? All right. Come on, then. Why doesn't somebody bloody well answer it? You're standing there. Hang on.
You know what time it is.
Oh, it's about six, isn't it? Has anyone got the right time?
6:05. Now, if you don't turn that racket off, I shall definitely inform the police.
Will somebody turn the tape recorder off? You have to unplug it, because the button doesn't work. Oh, I'm sorry about this,
now,
mate.
Look, son, I've warned you before.
Yeah, I know.
What's going on in there?
Eh?
What are you doing?
That's all right. They're making a film about me. I'm going to be on the telly.
Tell them to turn that camera off.
Hey?
I refuse to be filmed. Turn that thing off. What the bloody hell are you playing at?
I could play Stairway to Heaven when I was 12. Jimmy Page didn't actually write it until he was 22. I think that says quite a lot.
Did they get it this time?
What?
And have they got another hair in the gate or what?
Shut up, then.
Hey?
I said shut up. Oh, crap, so shall we go again?
No, I'll go with this one.
What is crap?
No, we can cut the beginning off.
It's just mic working. Hello, 1, 2.
Yes.
Dan, 1, 2.
Dan, yes, it's working. Look, we're wasting a lot of film here.
Okay, keep cool. Right, you ready, then?
What?
Oh, God, come on!
I'm ready.
Get back inside, then.
Let's go over the other side, Oliver.
Go in now.
Door.
OK.
Hello, Jen.
Hello, Alan.
Vim.
Hey?
Vim, my name's Vim, remember?
Oh, yeah, sorry. Hello, Vim.
Right. Hello, Den. You got your stuff ready, then?
Yeah. It's right here in the hall.
Well, come on, then. We've got to pick up the others yet.
All right, Alan. Oh, sorry. Right, Vim. Vim. Right. Okay, I'm off now, man. Bye.
Den used to be in this group called the Hounds of Zara. They were rubbish, right, but all you had to do to join was drink half a bottle of vodka and keep it down.
Here he is.
He tried 6 times before he got in.
He's standing outside so we don't see how posh his house is.
Morning, Colin.
Hi, Dan.
Well, I mean, the only thing that's wrong with Colin is that, you know, he can't really play.
How's it going with you, mate? All right?
Yeah.
I feel a bit wrecked, actually. Yeah. Bloody hell, it's a bit cramped in here, isn't it? Yeah, I feel a bit wrecked, you know.
Did you see the whistle test last night?
Sort of, yeah, but I was really stoned, you know, and I drank a bottle of brandy and... Yeah, I was with this chick and we were just about to get down to it. I went and put my foot through the television set.
Ah, no!
Yeah, so it sort of blew up a bit, you know, and set fire to the curtains and, well, I missed the second half of the show, so...
I bet your mum was really angry.
But she wasn't there. Was she, Dan?
Yeah, but I mean, when she gets back, she's going to be really angry.
She won't be getting back.
How come?
Because she's dead.
Hey? She's dead, Dan.
Oh, I get it. Alan's called Vim and your mum's dead. Can we cut this bit as well, please?
Where is he?
Which is his bedroom, do you think?
Don't come on, Spot!
Hey, what time did you call this in?
Oh, I smashed the window, Spider. Sorry.
Never mind, then. It's all anarchy, isn't it?
Look, are you ready now, then?
No, sorry. I've got to go and sign on at 10:30.
What?
No.
Don't get it?
Very funny.
Here's your bag, Spider.
Hey, babe, you're my bag.
Oh, Spider!
This is it. Just cry like I told you to, you won't get paid.
Hmm? Oh, no, Spider, don't leave me, not now!
Chicks, huh? See
you,
doll.
Well, Spider used to have this really big drug problem. You know, he couldn't get enough.
Shut the door.
That's probably why he's like he is, you know. Completely crazed. He's a bloody good drummer, though, you know. When I auditioned him, he did a 46-minute drum solo. I mean, he would have done a lot more, but I can't stand drum solos. Life on the road is a lot more interesting than working in a factory. I mean, you do a lot more driving about, for a start. You always feel as if you're going somewhere, you know?
Kinky. Hey, listen.
You making a film then?
Chase.
Yeah. I'm a rock star.
What, you're an actor?
Yeah, no, I'm a rock star. Bad news on the road.
Oh, with a band?
Yeah, can't you read?
Look, come on, Chase, we're going to be late. We've heard of them anyway.
Listen, I could teach you a lot of things you've never heard of,
though. Don't you be so rude. Come on, Chase.
Hey, listen, freak out, sugar. Come with us to Grantford.
Yeah. Can I really be in film?
Yeah, you got it on, babe. You're
going
to be a star.
Come on,
Spider. Come on, babe. Listen, it'll be all right.
Oh, come on, Mum. He's got a Durex in his pocket.
Well, I'll be all right then, won't I?
Trace!
See you later, Cheryl.
Well, this is surprising, isn't it? This is Colin. This is Ben.
What's your name?
Hey.
Trace. Do you like heavy metal, Trace?
Yeah.
Bye.
Our lifestyles have got a lot better. I mean, we're not rich yet, but I mean, it's obvious that we're going to be. So, you know, we don't worry so much about money.
£2.05, please, love.
2 quid?
That's right. £2.05, please.
2 quid for one bloody sausage?
That's right, love. £2.05.
Right, where's the camera? Look, what's the name of this place? Well, anyway, it's a rip-off. Look, they're charging 2 quid for one bloody sausage. So don't come here.
It was clearly marked, love. Sausage, beans and chips. £2.05.
Well, I haven't got 2 quid, have I? Can I have half a sausage for a quid?
No, you can't.
Hey, bad news.
Hey, Sally Friedman.
Britain's number one sexy chick rock journalist.
What gives? Coast to coast tour?
Putting heavy metal back on a rock and roll map where it belongs.
1001 smash motel rooms.
We're on... No, I still can't read that thing from here. Wait a minute, I was sitting over there.
Just carry on, Ken. Carry on.
No, no, it's not. It's going to be wrong. You see, it's meant to join up with that last bit, isn't it? Yeah, that's what I thought. Well, I was sitting over there then, right? I mean, how come I'm suddenly sitting over here now?
He's all right. I was sitting there.
OK, let's get the your favourite books, films, records and
wait a minute.
Experiences.
It says sausages up there. Not just one sausage. Look at that, look, it says sausages. Where's me other sausage then?
OK, let's cut the your favourite films, books, records and funniest experiences right. routine and get right down to the meat.
Let me tell you my funniest experience.
Shut up, Dan, shut up.
Well, I mean, first of all, I'd like to make my position clear. Yeah. I'm in love with heavy metal. I know I should have some ideological theory to renounce all the overestablished musical forms as the worthless ego massaging opiates they so obviously are. But that said, you've got to differentiate between the crass commercial glittergonzos and those who, though dismissed as unfashionable by casual chaps in this year's slacks, refuse to be bullied out of their belief in the fundamental values of popular music and sweat at their own temperature. What side of the fence are you on?
Right, about what you were saying before, it's a valid question. I mean, don't get me wrong about that, but I think you're really starting out from the wrong point of view, because we're not basically a heavy metal band. We're a bit more subtle than that. Aren't we, Colin?
What?
We're a bit more subtle than that.
Yeah, we're subtle, but basically, we're heavy metal, aren't we?
Yeah, Colin's right, Tim. If we made a record, it'd be so heavy you couldn't get off the turntable.
Yeah, look, I know that, but I mean, what I'm saying is we're just not simple heavy metal, you know.
I thought we were heavy metal.
I know we've got heavy roots, you know. And I mean, what I'm trying to say is that we're trying to progress a bit, you know, we're trying to break a few barriers.
Are we?
Yeah. Hmm. And that.
Carry on.
Well, I mean, if I relate it back to what you were saying, we're not sitting on a fence at all. We're trying to burn the fence down. And, yeah, and it's pretty stupid to sit on a burning fence. There's no point in being shackled to some stupid label.
Yeah, but what if the label is EMI?
That's not the point, Viv. What she's saying is that the label's not important. It's just a convenient term of reference.
Yeah, here we go, Colin, the college boy.
Well, it's obvious. What's wrong with being a heavy metal band anyway? Yeah. She would put heavy metal in the advert, that's why I joined.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, no, I know I did, but things change, don't they? I mean, when I was a kid, I used to play John Denver numbers all the time. But that doesn't mean that I have to be a prat all my life, does it?
You said it, Bim. Unless we can call ourselves Heavy Denver.
That's really funny,
yeah, that's
Spider.
True.
Heavy Denver.
Tell her to shut up or get out, Spider.
Shut up or get out.
Look! Look, we are not just another stupid heavy metal band.
What about futuristic heavy metal?
But we're more modern than futuristic, aren't we?
I know. What about heavy metal that's a Billy Romantic?
Yeah! Sorry, I forgot.
What are you doing, Den?
Right, that's it. I'm getting out of here if we're anything to do with the New Romantics.
One of the things about being a leader, right, is that you've got to sort out arguments that come up between people in the group. And you've got to be fair and you've got to make sure your own ego doesn't get in the way.
Come on, Dan, it was only a joke.
I don't care if it was a joke or not.
Tell me,
it was a joke. I'm not going any further until I hear Alan say that we're heavy metal.
Come on, tell him, Ben.
Okay, we're heavy metal, okay? Heavy metal! Have I said it enough? We're heavy metal, okay? It's like your fucking brain!
This is heavy, get it?
Bloody well told.
Mark, give me the radio.
Hello. Why have you stopped?
Hello. We all receiving you loud and clear. Over.
Cut the jargon and just answer the question, you stupid bastards.
Well, this is them. They're just watching you calling a stupid bastard, okay? Of your information, we've broken down, you stupid bastard.
Oliver, I'm not the subject of this documentary. Point the camera at the van. Because it's your problem, right? And you've got to handle it. We're just here to point the cameras, okay? That's the whole point of documentaries. Look, don't worry. It's going to look really good in the film anyway. It's great. It's really interesting. We're lucky it happened, actually.
You're lucky I don't knock your fucking head in.
There's no need to get violent, is there? And try not to swear so much, please, for
you
the sake of this film.
You can always put in a fucking bleep, can't you? Yeah.
Yes, that's not the point, though.
No, that's not the point, is it? The point is, how come you think you can interfere with the way we talk and not interfere when the van's broken down?
Yeah, right.
Answer that and stay fashionable.
Come on, boys, let's keep cool. We got
fuck
an awful
off.
Lot.
Fuck off.
Don't talk to me like that.
Cut it!
Cut it!
It's obvious we're going to make it. I mean, we're the only band I know that can play a 13-bar boogie. I mean, all we got to do is make a record and sell it. I mean, we'd be as rich as the Stones if we'd sold as many records as them.
Robbie, you've been manager of the Roxy now for 15 years. This was...
Anybody want this last cheese one?
There's not much, is there?
No.
And I thought they laid on lots of, you know, food and drink and that.
Excuse me.
What thing are you doing?
Hey?
This is my office. This is my office. I'm supposed to be in here.
Your office?
And what are you doing eating my tea?
What?
Sorry, mate, we thought this was the dressing room.
No. The dressing room's out there.
Oh, all I can see is the toilet.
Yeah?
Oh, I see.
Well, not the bloody toilet again.
Look, I came to tell you they're ready for a sound check.
Yeah, all right. Look, though, we've got to sort out this toilet business, though, all right?
Right on, man. You don't have to go yet, do you?
What?
Listen, love. Sound checks are very boring.
You're supposed to come in there, Colin.
All I'm asking, Vim, is that you let me sing just one number.
Yeah, I know. And I say you can't, OK?
Well, it's just not fair.
Look, this is my band, so it's fair.
Well, if that's the way it is, it's my brother's PA, and I say that you all can't use it.
The only reason you're in this band is because you've got the bloody PA.
Well, maybe I should take my PA to a band where I might be appreciated a little bit more.
Well, it'd better be a band in Grantham then, because it's not going back in my van.
Yes, which I paid for to have repaired.
Oh, lads, I'm afraid that's all it's time for, eh?
Yeah, I know it's a terrible bump, but the van broke down.
No, it's because the van really broke down, but,
Mum, could you take some library books back for me? Yeah, they're Blair's Origins of Feudal Britain.
Quo, Motorhead, Saxon, Uriah Heep, sure, and loads of bands. And you can quote me on that, sure, yeah. Yeah, okay, thanks, goodbye. See ya. Okay, ciao.
Right, yeah.
Another reporter.
How did you get into the music business, Spider?
Well, I went down to the job centre and told them I wanted to blow their minds.
Do you always play the pin tables before a gig?
No, you asked me to because you thought I'd make a nice shot.
Dan!
Who's that?
It's Sally.
What are you doing in here? This is the men's.
I've come to interview you.
Well, I'm on the toilet.
Why, is that because you're nervous?
No. Oh, I see what you mean. You thought I was shitting bricks. Mm-hmm. Well, I am. But it's got nothing to do with nerves. It's just like this problem I got. You'll know when I'm nervous because I throw up.
Yeah, I know, because I was born to be on stage, you know.
Thanks. How do you know?
Well, I mean, what can you do when you're multi-talented? I mean, you can't just sit at home in a coma. I could have been a Michelangelo, could have been Wordsworth. Joe Bugner, anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is strong stuff, isn't it?
Yeah. It certainly does the job all right, doesn't it?
Well, how's it that I can stand up?
What?
Are you going to sleep with me tonight?
What?
Are you going to sleep with me tonight?
I know what. Sally. Sally, I thought you told me this thing was fixed.
I'm listening now.
Oliver, what are you still running for?
Haven't said cut yet.
Well, doesn't it appear a bit obvious sometimes?
Well, now, you said the art of making documentaries was to keep running all the time.
It's cut out.
Are you nervous now, Dan?
No, I think it must be something I ate.
Yeah. Looks like everything you ate. Come on, we're gonna get on stage now. Come on, Tim, what's happening? Come on, man.
Right.
Rock and roll, man.
Sorry.
One, two, three, four.
I think I can handle fame. I mean, I think I'm ready for it, you know. I mean, I've had fame before because I was on Opportunity Knocks when I was a kid. Yeah, that's when I was 11. I did Purple Haze on the acoustic guitar with my dad on the trumpet. It's a bit naff, I suppose, really, but I mean, it was a good experience. We got quite a following now, you know. Not me and my dad, I mean the band, you know. You can't beat a good live band. I mean, I just live for playing live. I mean, I'd do it for free if I didn't need the money.
Thank you.
the buzz that you get off the audience is amazing. I mean, it's the audience that makes a gig, you know. When you're on stage there, and there's this huge crowd of people all sweating and jumping about and all enjoying themselves. And it's all because of you.
One, two, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Hey, lads. I just wanted to say it was a great gig, tremendous.
Well, thanks very much.
Yeah, thanks.
Did you think that when
the money? What about the money?
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm afraid there isn't any.
What?
Well, you saw them out there tonight, didn't you? Four people.
Don't forget the dog.
Yeah, you didn't let the dog in free, did you?
I don't understand. We were on a straight 40 quid. There was no box office or nothing.
Look, I said I'm sorry, didn't I? I'll go and check it out, OK?
Who are you married to?
They did a good job on that skull, didn't they?
Yeah. And that smoke was quite good, too.
Yeah. Well?
Can't find him. Must have buggered off.
Bastard.
It's not his fault. I think he's quite nice.
You shut up, you tart. He's trying to get out of paying me.
Well, that bloke told him not to.
What?
He told him not to pay you.
What, him?
Yeah.
What, is that right?
Oh, look, don't worry. You'll get your money. I'm just trying to make it a bit more interesting, you know. Create a bit of conflict. Yeah?
Yeah. Well, I mean, if it's conflict you're looking for...
Oh! Look, don't do that!
And it's going to stop that!
Get the police, Mark!
Get the camera, Dan!
Yeah, I'm on a report.
Keep rolling, Oliver!
Keep rolling, Oliver!
We've got to borrow this a minute, man. Pip! Come on, Pip! We've got the sound gear.
Look, just get up to the office. We'll get up to the office and we'll start it. Take one of the
documentary. Okay, I think the tape recorder's working. It's going round
anyway. Come on, Colin. Why don't you let me help you?
Look, then? Just keep your hands off it, Den.
What about that button there?
Yeah, there you are. Look, I can hear it now. Must be on.
All right. So it's on. Do you just get back? I'm trying to get in focus.
Come on, Spider.
Hello, Spider.
Brilliant joke, Dean.
Thanks.
Okay, it's
right,
working.
Now, does everybody know what they're doing?
Yes.
Yeah. I just say, heavy metal, top of the class, stuff the media up your arse.
Yeah, don't forget to get your cock out, Dean.
Hey? Look, don't confuse him, Spider.
Hang on.
Oh, God, get it together, for Christ's sake.
Will you just stop shouting at me, Alan? It's beginning to get on my tits.
Piss off and stop calling me Alan.
All right, then Ajax, or whatever your new name is.
Just don't you dare wind me up.
I think we've run out of film.
What?
Yeah, we've run out of film.
Oh, God.
It's all right. There's some more over here.
Den, don't touch...
Den.
What'd you go and do that for?
What?
Never take new film out of a tin. We've got no film left now. It's a complete waste of time.
Oh, I'll put it back then.
God, Den, you're stupid! That's the point. You know what?
What?
This band is a pile of shit.
Eh?
Hang on, everybody. We're going to run out of tape soon. Yeah, here it comes. Any moment. Now. Now, hang on, I was wrong. It's going to be about...
You My name's Sally Friedman, so-called rock journalist extraordinaire and self-confessed rock and roll addict. 5 years ago, I took the road with a bunch of rock amateurs. 6 months on the road later, they'd matured into an outfit as tight as a facelift. And then suddenly, inexplicably, and very publicly, they split up.
Too much sex and drugs and rock and roll.
Colin was behaving like a complete prat. Den could only string two chords together, and Spider was out of his head on drugs all the time.
Well, apparently, it was all Colin's fault. I don't know what happened, really. I mean, one day we're getting along fine, you know, looking forward to the gig at Stockport. Next morning I woke up and they'd all buggered off.
I blame myself in part, you know. I mean, I was always really the Keith Moon of the group, you know. I was always getting drunk. I was really funny when I was drunk.
Then I hurt my finger and I couldn't play guitar properly. And it went septic, so I couldn't play properly for about 3 months. And it was my important finger. Look.
You're a very visual band indeed.
Well, you still want to do an interview?
Yes, yes, please, yes, yes.
Do you want? I think it's probably just me.
Well, no, what? We can have all the band in. Whatever.
I just wasn't getting my own way enough of the time, you know, and, well, you can only be reasonable for so long, can't you?
Thank you, thank you.
We are a live band, basically, but I don't think anybody guessed that we were miming.
Everybody shut up!
Well, that was 4 years ago. But what happens to those dreams of stardom? What happens to the boys who are sure they got it right, the boys who think, hey, we're going to make it?
Some people aren't quite good enough at playing the bass, OK? It means that you couldn't actually play it well enough!
What's the name? Vim Fuego, what kind of name is that?
We thought we'd find out by arranging a reunion gig for them here at their old stomping ground, the Flying Horse, where they used to deliver the excitement and escapism that so few bands do these days, where they violated with voltage and volume, outraged parents, and erected rock dreams against the world. Hi. Vim Fuego, you are the creator and driving force behind the legend that was Bad News, and as such have carried the burden of dreams, stroke nightmares, stroke whatever. The reunion of a band that split so acrimoniously must be packed with conflicting emotions of joy, guilt, anger, anxiety, despair, hope, excitement even. How do you feel?
All right, thanks. How are you?
And now you're getting the band back together again?
Yeah. But where, oh, where can they be?
When was the last time that you saw them all?
Well, the only one I've seen recently is,
Who's that?
Colin. After the band split up, he went straight back to college. Studied land management for 3 years, then failed his exams. Ended up working as a clerk in a bank.
God, God.
What do I think of him? I think he's a banker.
Oh, God. Oh. Mummy! Mummy! Yes.
Hi, Colin, it's Sally Friedman, remember?
Colin?
Yeah, hi.
No. No, I'm not Colin. I'm Trevor. I'm Trevor, Colin's twin brother. If you want Colin, he'll probably be round at his pad, because he's frightfully groovy. Groovier than me, anyway. Mommy!
do you want me to begin?
Well, did you stay on at college?
God, no, no. I just quit the band and dropped out of college at the same time. Well, I felt like I really wanted to find myself. You know, it's... oh, God, I had an amazing time. I just went wild. Yeah. I was like a crazy man. I mean, I shacked up with punks. Dyed my hair. All sorts of exotic colours. I almost had a drugs overdose. Mm-hmm. I mean, I just generally tried to experience as much as I could.
Oh, wow, that's really amazing.
Well, it is, yeah.
So what do you do now?
I can't remember. Look, you said you weren't going to ask me that question.
Tell me about Denver.
Oh, I haven't got a clue there, I'm afraid. I haven't seen or heard nothing about him since the band split up. You know, I've tried getting in touch with him through the spirits, but I haven't been able to pick up his vibe.
What?
Oh, yeah, I forgot to tell you. Since the last time we met, I've become, well, metaphysical, I suppose you'd call it. You know, I've discovered I've got this power to, like, talk to people from beyond the grave. You know, in fact, I've been talking to some pretty interesting people from recent rock history, actually. I mean, they never give me any whole songs or anything like that. Well, the nearest I ever came to that was one that John gave me a lot of help with, John Lennon. Called Imogen.
Imagine?
No, Imogen, it's a girl's name. You know, the title's just a really sort of strange coincidence, really. Yeah. Oh, I'll play it to you if you like. I've got my studio in the cellar. Do you want to have a listen?
Come on, let's go down the studio.
Yeah.
It's this way.
Hang on. There's someone at the door. Bloody hell, Ten, it's you.
Who do you think it was going to be?
Well, this is a surprise.
What's going on here?
Fancy you turning up now, at this precise moment.
Yes, well, I finished the job in Corsica Street. I told you it'd only take half a day. It's a film crew, isn't it? Hey, you're that bloke who was a cameraman on that documentary we've done, aren't you? Oh, nice to see you. Yeah, was it Oliver, isn't it? That's right. How are you doing? What's going on, Vin?
Can you cut it there? And power on. Choose rhythm, change the rhythm. Don't want bossa nova. No. See, it's a new machine, you see. Alright, I'll just. Would you go with that, right? Synchro start, flashing. Okay, here comes. 2, 3, 4!
Imagine all the people!
It sounds better without a bossa nova, you know. Spider, the wild man who could throw up exactly half a pint into an half-pint pot with no spillage, had to marry this strange hippie woman because he got her pregnant. She's really tamed him. A lot.
Let's pop some pills and get completely out of control.
I don't know whether we'll get him back in a band or not, because he's under the thumb, you know. Don't know if she'll let him go. So we'll have to discuss it with her, you know, and we'll just hope for the best.
I've got to go.
Well, if you got to.
Yeah, well, you know, I've got to, really.
Well, all right, then.
Well, that was a pretty good discussion, wasn't it?
Rock and roll, here we come.
Dan, the old mate.
Nice one.
Good to see
you. How you doing?
Yeah, all right.
How are you? All right. Yeah.
Nice.
Hi, Spider.
Oh, Colin, you old tosser. Hey, how are you doing?
I'm very cool, thank you. Very cool indeed.
Good.
All right. Hello, Vin.
Colin.
Well.
Hey.
Great.
Like to see the menu, sir?
I think we'd like to order some drinks first, eh?
Yeah, sure. 4 pints of lager, please?
No, let's have 8 pints.
No, 16.
Oh. No, 32.
No, bugger it. We're a rock band, make it 100.
How many pints would you like?
100.
Are you serious, sir?
No, I'm being serious. We'd like 100 pints of lager, please.
100 pints of lager?
Look, you heard what he said, didn't you? We want 100 pints of lager.
Yeah, come on, Channel 4 are paying, all right.
I went 4 poppadoms. That'll do for starters.
We're going to get really pissed.
All the, not rested for a second, you know.
Yeah. See, you never stopped playing then, Vim.
No, I couldn't stop playing because it's in my blood, right? You know, I mean, if I stop playing, it'll be like something really important stopping.
Important stopping.
Yeah.
Because you've been playing that wine bar Sunday lunchtime, haven't you?
Yeah. What?
Wine bar? Yeah, he's been playing Mary Hopkins numbers on acoustic guitar.
Shut up.
Those were days, my friend, we thought they'd never
end. Then just shut up,
right? Dear, that Spider, Vin Fuego, the great heavy metal guitarist, has been playing Mary Hopkins numbers in a wine...
I've been playing music.
If you can call Mary Hopkins music, then you have been playing.
I've kept on hawking on bloody old demo tape around, haven't I? And what have you been doing, Colin? What have you been doing? Working in a bank. That's what you've been doing, isn't it?
You probably
wouldn't mention
that.
Well, look, while we're
promised.
On, while we're on the subject of things we promised we wouldn't mention, maybe we should ask everyone to ask you why you're not going to play this reunion gig on Saturday.
All right, well, maybe I don't see what's so important about playing a one-off gig at the Flying Horse of all places. These people from Channel 4 still give us the money even if we don't do the gig, won't you?
Yeah, you know, I'll see what's so great about playing a one-off gig. I suppose you want a record contract or something like that.
Maybe I do want a record contract. What's wrong with wanting a record contract?
All right. Have a look at that.
What is it?
It is a record contract. That's what you get if you don't turn traitor on your music and start working in a bank, Colin, right? And while we're talking, quite frankly, I might as well just say that the idea of playing with you makes me bloody sick, right? And if it wasn't for the record company insisting on the original lineup, you would not be in this f***ing band.
How many pints have I had?
42.
Right, I think it's time to be sick.
The last point on my list is this cosmic clause thing. Rights to exploitation on any planet now or yet to be known to man.
Yeah.
But what does that mean?
Oh, that's just a little bit of nonsense. I mean, all it means is when we land on Mars, we find lots of little Martians there, who, let's face it, are bound to be into bad news, we can sell your records to them.
Oh, far out. OK.
Right, so to sum up the main points again. The contract lasts 5 years. But you don't have to put out any records if you don't want to. Although if you don't want to, we're still under contract to you, and we're not allowed to make any records for anybody else. And we get 4.75% of 90% of 100, minus 15% of retail. But there's no advance, which means absolutely no cash whatsoever for us up front.
Yeah, that's about right, yeah.
Well, all right, I'll sign that.
Hey, where's all the groupies?
Yeah, where's all the groupies?
Where's all the drugs?
Where's the toilet?
Hey, look out, world, you're about to witness rock and roll history!
Yeah, the only trouble with creating rock and roll history is it always takes 6 hours to set the drums up. Why is that, Spider?
Well, this time it's because I left my drums at home. No, I'm serious.
What?
I thought this lot were going to pick them up for me.
Oh, this is really great. Just imagine, I could have just dumped in the same bog as Eric Clapton. Or Mick Jagger. Or Lemmy. Or Ozzy Osbourne. Who has been here? Bananarama.
Bloody hell, who's all those lagers?
Oh, I brought them in there for afterwards.
Look out thinking, Rachel. Hey, lads! There's a stack of lager in here!
No, come on. I said they were for afterwards.
Free lager.
Well, all right, you can have one now, but just one, OK?
Well, this lot shouldn't take long.
Down. It's pathetic. You couldn't amplify a fart through that.
Yeah, well, Gail's kid's gerbil's been using it for a toilet the last 3 years.
Well, you can't play through that, can you? Look, mate, have you got a spare amp we could borrow or something?
Bloody hell, Vim, look, it's a Marshall.
Hey. Listen, mate, have you got any more of these?
No, that's it.
Look, Den, maybe I should play through the Marshall, right? And you can play through my stack.
No, wait, this one's mine now.
No, well, let me just have a try. Den, Den, stop being childish, don't!
Why? For me!
Set up, just try straight in. Nice one, Dave. Can you turn it up a bit? Just take me up a bit. Yeah? Up a bit more. Just a touch more.
Shut up.
Can go up a little bit higher, can't it? I know. All right, just another two or three notches. Good. Yes. Well, just a little bit more. Okay. Up a touch. Up just a touch. Lovely. Okay, we'll try it there. Hey, joke.
Knickers on.
Yeah, don't get your hair in a twist.
We've been playing this number on and off for 6 years. We could play it with our hands tied behind our backs.
Yeah, well, get on with it then.
Yeah, all right. Well, should we give it a go then?
Yeah, I'll set really? The yeah.
All right, let's tie our hands behind our backs.
We are the four horsemen of the rock apocalypse. Leaders and saviors of the wild ride to oblivion and ecstasy.
1, 2, 3.
God's sake, then!
I was playing a G.
You weren't!
I was.
You weren't! I was watching you!
I was playing a G.
You weren't! You were playing this! What's that? What is it, eh?
That's a D.
Yeah, that's a D, and that's what you were playing.
No, I wasn't. I was playing a G.
If you were playing a G, then I'm a queer.
We always had our doubts about you, Vin.
Yeah, well, maybe you are bloody queer.
What's wrong, Vin?
You know perfectly well what's wrong.
What, that you might be a queer?
Don't be so f***ing stupid. It's the band. I mean, what is it with this band? 6 years we've been playing that number. We finally got the chance to put it down on vinyl, and what happens? Nothing! Now, why is that?
Well, secretly, I'm rather pleased that Phil's left. Because, quite frankly, I don't think he's that hot. I just can't get a decent balance in my cans. It was the same thing that happened the last time we tried to record something. We didn't have the right people, and we don't have them now. We need a producer. We need a good engineer.
We need a proper bass player.
We need a proper Right, that is it. I'm off. I mean it, Vim, I'm off. You just can't say that sort of thing about me in front of the camera. I've seen you sneaking off and bad-mouthing me behind my back. Well, it doesn't matter what you say now. I'm going. I have had enough.
Bye, then.
It's just exactly what always used to happen, isn't it? And here you are doing it all over again. Well, it's not going to work this time because I'm going. Now! Right now! And don't try and stop me. I'm going now. There's no argument. I refuse to argue with you. You see, look, I'm refusing to argue with you. Goodbye.
A 1, 2, 3, 4.
I don't care what any of you say. I signed the contract too, and I refuse to be thrown out of the band just we're on the brink of success. Do you hear me, Vin? I refuse to leave.
Colin.
What?
Stop crying.
I'm not crying.
Turn the track out, mate.
Yes. Who's that playing bass? Who is it?
Playback! Action!
Now, when I've set off Spider, all you have to do when I cue you is turn into camera and look mean, okay? Right, let's go. Turn over.
Right.
Roll playback. Action, Spider. Action. Cut, cut, cut! What happened there?
Oh, sorry, I got confused. I thought you meant that car. I didn't see that camera.
Warriors of Genghis Khan is actually a political song.
Action, then! Action, then! Then! Action!
Oh, sorry. Sorry, I was watching Spider on the bike.
In what way is it a political song?
Well, it's in the lyrics, isn't it?
Action then. No, no, you have got to look mean.
Oh, right, sorry.
Right, here we are then. Burning, looting, raping, shooting, repeat. Burning, looting, raping, shooting.
that's political in intent, isn't there?
Well, maybe it's more poetical political, you know, I don't know.
It doesn't simply sort of indulge the macho male ego's preoccupying and overriding obsession with dominating women and orgiastic bloodletting for the sake of it, then?
Yeah, that's the bits I like.
Warriors of Genghis Khan by Bad News.
And, where Bad News?
Yeah. Are you really?
Yeah.
What was it called, sorry?
Warriors of Genghis Khan.
Warriors of Genghis Khan.
Huh. Sounds sensitive. No, we haven't got it, sorry.
No, it's new out this week.
Yeah.
What label's it?
Oh.
Frilly Pink! That's that new label, just for gays, is it? Hang on.
Shall I smash his face in?
No, I'm sorry, it's not him. Girls.
No,
Dead!
Excuse me.
Yeah?
We'd like Warriors of Genghis Khan by Bad News, please.
Oh, is that a new one?
Yeah, it's new out this week, actually.
Well, do you know what label it's on?
It's on Frilly Pink. Do you want to make something of it or what? I hate Barry Manilow.
Well, that is a surprise.
Here we are.
I know, we want more than one.
Well, how many do you want?
How many did we want, Collie?
347.
Yeah, 347, please.
Guys, listen to this. Tell them what you just told me.
Look, it's no secret. It was in the contract.
What was?
Go on, tell them!
Well, it's just that the video and the single come out of your royalties. It is standard practice.
I've worked it out. Do you know how much it comes to? I was talking to the guy who runs the canteen van. He says he charges £17.50 a head. That means with a crew this size, the canteen bill alone is going to come to something like £800. That meal over there is costing us £200 each! Eat as much as you can!
We paid for that!
Look, at the moment you're in debt to the tune of about 15 grand, but we'll get it back for you, don't worry.
What's the thing we're doing?
Bad news on that front, I'm afraid. Hey! Bad news, get it?
We must be somewhere in the charts. It's only 376.
We've been disqualified from the charts.
What?
Yeah.
Fuck it off! We paid for that.
Where are the bozos? Come on, somebody!
Apparently some twat went into a chart shop and bought 350 copies. Of course, when that happens, they think it's being hyped and they get disqualified from the charts for a couple of weeks. But don't worry, we'll re-release it on the back of this programme. That's when it'll do business. Should make some money at Castle Donington as well. I have booked you, Bad News, to play the Monsters of Rock Festival, Castle Donington.
Donington?
Another heavy metal day. No sleep till Castle Donington. Better have some vibes.
Donington, I mean, it's just unbelievable. I mean, it's like, it's the centre of the heavy metal universe, and Bad News are going to be there. I mean, the biggest gig we've played so far is 87, I think, at Kingston Poly.
Daddy, please put the power back on. OK, I'll turn it down.
I mean, this is big league, right? And all we got to do now is blow Ozzy off the stage.
I thought if you were going to play this getting up in the morning scene, I'd bring you a cup of tea like I normally do.
Oh, great. Tea, yeah, great. Thanks, Mrs. Grigson. Just put it down on the side. That'll be all.
To be so formal, Colin. I am your mother. Oh, I'm sorry about that. But your father has got a point, you know. When you've got a place of your own, you can make as much noise as you like.
I've got something a bit special for you, ladies and gentlemen. It's very big, it's very bad, it's called the Beast.
Bloody brakes don't work.
Alan Metcalf. Shut up, don't say a bit.
Thank you, Declan. Telephone number 01678-5397.
Yeah, stop filming that, please.
This isn't supposed to happen. This
All right, thanks. That's about it, really.
Yeah, well, actually, I don't see what's really wrong with living with your parents. I mean, they're just a couple of old reactionaries, and here I am sponging off them. So that's what I call anarchy in my book. Anyway, who's playing at Castle Donington, me or you? Hmm? It's me, isn't it?
I'm going to show you inside the Beast. See all this? This is all leopard skin. Vim and I did this. It's great, isn't it? You can get this for $8.99 a roll. It's a shop called Alexander's we bought it from. You can get the zebra or the tiger skin. We thought the leopard was a bit saucy, you know. This is, it's a picture of my Aunt Marjorie, actually. A few chicks. I've had all those. This is old Vim's furniture, basically. And that's the cockpit in there. There's our captain.
Good afternoon. I'd like to welcome you aboard. Hope you have a pleasant flight. As you can see in the flight deck, we've gone mainly for the skull motif. We've got the skull on the gear stick here. We've got the skulls on the mirror. We've got the out of date tax dish. We've got the optional extra saucy lady. Leopard skin throughout, of course. It's very metal, very heavy, and it's very bad news.
I was wondering if we could play a little game. I sometimes use it when I'm interviewing people for my column. It's called On the Couch. It's a word association game. Okay, I'll start. Heavy metal. Heavy metal.
Heavy metal what?
Heavy metal.
What about heavy metal?
Okay then, what about heavy metal?
Oh yeah, right. I like heavy metal.
Who's this?
My head.
Pet Shop Boys.
John Lowe's and Peter Purdy's.
Vim.
No, my name's Dan.
What's this journey gonna take? I wanna go to the toilet.
Well, it'd be a lot shorter if we didn't have to stop at every bridge to let the cameraman out to film us going by.
Wake up. Give us another word. I think I've got it now.
Right.
Give us another word.
AC/DC.
What about him?
Your passes, please.
It's all right, mate. We're with the film crew.
Nah. I said, can I see your passes, please?
Yeah, and I said, we're with the film crew.
I need to see a pass.
But we haven't got any, have we?
If you haven't got any passes, you don't get in.
Yeah, but we're doing a gig here tomorrow.
Look, if we don't get in, then we won't get to play. And I should think your superiors will be pretty upset with you, mate.
Yeah. Look, is there any chance of seeing someone in charge?
I'm in charge.
Right, well, look, we haven't got any passes, right? There's obviously been some sort of mix-up, but we are playing here tomorrow. We've got the gear in the van, and we need to get in.
If you haven't got a pass, you don't get in.
Right, well, in that case, we're not moving our van.
No. Yeah. Right. Turn that camera off, please.
What for? Ow!
I suppose you think that's funny, do you, Colin? To watch the guy who got you what must be probably the biggest gig you've ever had in your life get his ribs broken. That's funny, is it, eh?
Well, it is quite funny, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's quite funny.
Oh, that's very nice coming from you, Den. If it wasn't for me, you'd still be a painter and decorator.
I am still a painter and decorator. I've got that job for you in Hendon starting on Friday, remember?
Sorry about the mix-up with the gate, boys. It's just one of those things.
Yeah, well, what about a sound check?
Sound check?
Yeah.
Well, you're the ones with the film crew, aren't you? They told me it was a joke documentary about some funny rock band.
What?
So I'm afraid we haven't scheduled a sound check. Anyway, I'll tell you what. Have a look around and I'll catch up with you later, all right?
If what was said just then ends up in this documentary, I'm going to kill every single one of you.
This is where it's all going to happen. Bad news playing live in front of 250,000 people, and a lot of them chicks.
There's the toilets. I think there's 250,000 punters, and if all of them pissed about 2 pints each, then there'd be
when I'm rich, right, I'll get a mansion right next door to the doll office, and I'm gonna get a stereo with speakers this big.
I'm sorry I called you a completely bugger pisshead.
Oh, this is really great. I've never been in the hotel. You can drink all day.
Yeah, well, this is what it's going to be like from now on with bad news. World tours and all day drinking.
Yeah, and endless snobbing.
Yeah!
Hey, guys, let's get this introduction recorded properly, and then we can start to really, really, really get piddly.
Right, come on.
Come on,
let's do it.
Bad news!
This time.
Good evening, we are bad news.
Dead ass. Here we go, rock and roll. 2, 3, 4.
Good evening, we are bad news. And we bring you more bad news.
We are bad. Hey, listen. Let's pretend to be the Who.
Yeah, I'll do it. Hey, I'll be Keith Moon.
Yeah, and I'll be Pete Townsend.
No, I want to be Pete.
And you're Roger Daughtry.
I'll be
be that other one that nobody knows who he is.
Yeah. I should be Pete Townsend, because I play the guitar.
No, I'm Pete Townsend. Listen, I'm Pete Townsend.
You can't bounce Pete Townsend.
I can do whatever I want. It was my idea to join the Who. I need to pretend to be the Who. It's my idea. You've got to be Roger Daughtry.
Why can't you be Roger Daughtry?
Because I'm not a queer.
Bad news at 10.
Bad news, the cast of Donington tomorrow. Bad news, the cast of Donington tomorrow.
No, Adam, please, I'm sorry. Don't. Oh, my God. Adam, please, help. Don't hurt me.
You're making a documentary.
If you have changed the shape of my nose in any way whatsoever, Alan Metcalf, I'm going to sue you. And I mean that.
If we don't get a bloody cast of Donington tomorrow, I'll kill you.
We really must stop meeting like this.
What are we going to do now,
Maybe
Vim?
You should have a word with Jimmy, Vim. Maybe he could help you.
Oh, Jimmy, you ain't heaven. Hendrix me, I know. Thunder me,
took on the whole of the Nottingham Constabulary! And they lost! Last night they were all in jail. That was at 4 o'clock in the morning. At 2 o'clock this afternoon, by some miracle they got out on bail, and they're here for you now. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome Bad News!
They're an insult to like professional musicians. I mean, the fact that, like, you know, they've been allowed to go on stages, you know, that have been, you know, trod upon by, like, so many famous faces in the past, it's a disgrace. To me, it's just giving rock a really bad name. I mean, bands like ours, I mean, we've been, like, you know, going around circuits for years, and all they get is, like, one documentary.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like sort of like, you know, heavy metal Sheen Easton.
I'm Phil Collins, guitarist from Def Leppard, and I think they're shit.
The worst band I've ever seen in the world. They were absolutely awful.
Bad news? Ha ha ha! Hi, sir!
I thought Bad News had a new high in altruistic, self-indulgent bullshit, mollycoddle, you know, mother my dog instinct rock and roll. I thought it was a piece of pimply shit from the worst kind of city ghetto, probably populated by winos, junkies and just general all-round
we
the first number went quite well. Well, the first part of it did. The audience got a bit bored in the second half. And then Vim said, "Behold, I am the reincarnation of Jimi Hendrix. All kneel and praise me." And that's when the audience rushed the stage. No, it wasn't just Hell's Angels, it was the police as well, all like jumping on Vim's head. And then Colin joined in, and so Vim's in major surgery at the moment, and it looks quite dodgy, evidently. Anyway, luckily, Colin had his wig, like, torn off, so he could pretend he wasn't in the band. Until someone saw this name tag on his collar and they slit his throat. I only got off so lightly because, like, I was so scared, I went to the toilet in my trousers, and most people, like, kept away from me because of the smell. And Spider got out of being beaten up by blowing himself up. Yeah, it's a tragedy, yeah. Yeah, but on the other hand, look, Rachel says it'll probably do the record a lot of good. And if Vim dies and we exploit it properly, we could all make a lot of money. So, it's a pity, yeah, but there you go.